The way I look at myself, if I ever do, is as I'm a man of extremes, and I think every character is made up of a load of ingredients, and I just think I have a very soft side and a very hard side. So if the right person gets me, they'll find me that I'm very vulnerable and I can be a real baby if they find me the right time. At the same time, I'm very strong and very hard, and there's no half measures with me.
This film tells the untold stories surrounding Freddie Mercury, casting light on the man behind the music and tracing his strangely unpublicized roots to exotic shores. Come with us on a journey back through time and culture to the land and birth of Farrokh Bulsara. Though only a tiny speck in the atlas, Zanzibar casts long shadows across the imagination. Whether the 1950s reality of this old Arab trading post matched the perceived glamour of Sinbad, sultans, slaves and spices is, of course, another matter. And when it comes to throwing light on those early days, no one alive could possibly surpass this guide.
I'm Jo Bulsara, Freddie's mummy.
Nothing in Zanzibar acknowledges or celebrates the importance of Freddie Mercury, a situation that artist John De Silva, an elder school friend of Freddie's, would like to see rectified.
There must be something, a kind of a plaque or something like that on Freddie Mercury. I think Freddie has built himself up so well, and that impact is certainly, Zanzibar would certainly gain from that.
I'm Cash Cook, Freddie's sister.
It's very tropical, beautiful beaches, beautiful sea, very hot. And that's exactly what it is. Unspoilt, dirty, smelly. It's all right as a holiday place, but not to live in, I'm afraid.
So catch me if you can. I'm going.
He was born on 5th September 1946, and funny enough, it happened to be on our Parsi New Year's Day.
In this very hospital, the government hospital Zanzibar, on the 5th of September 1946, Farrokh Bulsara first saw the dazzling light of the world.
Siku ya Alhamis tarehe 5 mwezi wa 9 mwenye afya nzuri akiwa na uzito wa ratili 7 mtoto huyo alipewa jina la Farrokh.
The name we selected for him is Farrokh. That was his birth name. That was the name at that time, very fashionable in the Parsis, and I just wanted to name him that, you know.
The world into which little Farrokh was born was a placid tropical paradise, whose ancient white walls and thin ramshackle streets allowed fleeting glimpses of green leaves against azure waters and white coral sands. Born into a high-ranking Parsi family working for the British government, he was in the public eye virtually from birth after his baby picture won a local Photo of the Year contest.
For ourselves, very sociable, very friendly people and all that. But for the children, like Freddie and all growing up, there wasn't much to do. Not much excitement and all.
The start of Farrokh's day is his walk to school down these narrow stone town streets. Soaking up and savouring the cultural flavours of the Arab street traders, East African fishermen and colonial expatriates he rubs shoulders with. Stopping off along the way at Kamlour's restaurant, whose courtyard was his favoured sanctuary and social nexus, a place for games and gossip of the kind exchanged by adults on the city's white stone benches. Even then, his favourite spot was Stone Town's harbour, where he would watch the passing ships, dreaming of faraway places and foreign music.
We used to play different music, Indian music, folk music, English and all that, and he just used to pick up one of the records and start singing about it. So he had a variety of tastes in music. When we used to go to functions and parties, and used to sing, obviously, whenever somebody asked him, he used to sing, and he used to feel so proud to make everybody happy, even at that age.
Happiness is the most important thing, and if I'm happy, then it shows in my work, and so basically I just want to be happy and make a lot of money and buy a lot of things.
In this photo shop, the Capital Art Studio, the very first pictures of Farrokh were taken.
Many people, they are even, they were very young and now they are very big men, they still remember my studio. So since we were young and we come to take photograph today, it's the same studio like this. You didn't change. I said, I don't want to change. I want to keep like that, you know. You can bring your children and your grandchildren, you'll find same as it is.
Almost every Zanzibari has sat for pictures in this room, unchanged since the days when Farrokh posed here. This man, the current owner's father, photographed Farrokh just as he documented the rest of the island's Parsi community, then a far larger group.